beautiful people, welcome back. I hope everyone is having a fantastic day today. And in today's video, we are gonna be doing a little video I like to call Makeup I Never Tested, where we are sitting down and testing out makeup that I picked up or, you know, acquired at some point throughout the year, and I've just never tested. With these videos, they could be products that I received in PR, they can be stuff I found randomly on like Ulta, Walmart, Walgreens, stuff like that, or even just stuff that I get in a BoxyCharm. Like, I try to throw everything in here. I just really try to play around with it, make it something a little bit fun, you know, where we can really play around with makeup that is not a new release. At least I think maybe there's one item in here that's like a newer-ish launch. Obviously we'll talk about it, but I like to just play around with these because it's a fun way to play with makeup that's not new but that I've never tested. That way there's no, you know, pressure. It's not like some crazy in-depth where we have to examine it from all angles and be like super hypercritical. It's just more of a fun laid-back way to still play with makeup, stuff that I'm curious about, stuff that you guys are curious about, but you know, just stuff that we never talked about for whatever reason. Not gonna lie, guys, I'm actually really excited going into this one. There is some makeup in here that I have been dying to test out, and for whatever reason I just haven't had a chance to, so I'm super pumped. I am gonna go ahead and throw my hair back, you guys. I was trying to let it air dry naturally and it just this is not the look. So I'm gonna go ahead and throw this back. Oh, before we do any of that, obviously, hello, if you're new here, subscribe before you leave, if you like me, that is. Hello, if you vibe with me, if you're like, hey, this is kind of my lady, and you want to stick around, obviously I would appreciate it. Like I said, subscribe, turn on your post notifications. I do upload 3 new videos a week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Typically I upload 3 days a week. I don't want to be over here shooting myself in the foot or nothing, but like, seriously, this last Friday was a disaster. If you follow me on Instagram, which also follow me on Instagram, hi, cheap plug, I had a whole situation. The video wouldn't upload. I tried it day after day after day, and finally I was just like, you know what, I'm done. Like, I quit with this video. So I figured we would just start fresh. We're starting off this week good to go. But anyways, like I said, do all of that down below. Oh, and yes, follow me on Instagram, I post a ton over there as well. There's everything plus size fashion, makeup IGTV, makeup reels. I do post a ton in my stories, whether they're just like funny story times, which I had a lot of this past weekend. I had to go to Walmart, it was a whole thing. You guys, anytime you go to Walmart, I feel like you have like a 97% chance of leaving with a pretty good story. I left with 2. So definitely make sure you follow me on Instagram. That's pretty much it. So let's go ahead, like I said, fix this hair and get it, put some back, put it back on the back of my head, okay? So we can get into this makeup because I am so excited. Let's do it. All right, so we're good and zoomed in. Also, can we just pay homage to this shirt, okay? The woman, the myth, the legend, the queen that is Shania Twain. Oh my God, you guys, I love Shania Twain so much. And fun fact, okay, this photo right here is actually from her The Woman in Me album, and that was my very first CD I ever purchased. And yes, I might have just dated myself, okay, but I don't even care because we were on our way to go visit my grandmother downstate, because obviously I live in good old Northern Michigan, okay, if you don't know. And we were on our way down to Detroit where my grandmother lived, and we stopped off at, I think it was a Target, I want to say, because everything was red, and I had never seen a Target because, again, good old Northern Michigan. And so, because I live far enough north that, like, what's a Target, right? Like, I didn't know. And we got down there, and there was just, like, this wall of CDs, and I was mesmerized. Like, I literally just stood there and was, like, looking at all the CDs, right? I was so into it. And I remember my dad walked over to me, and because I was holding a Shania Twain CD, because I loved Shania Twain. I heard her on the radio, right? And my dad was like, do you know who that is? I said, this Shania Twain. Now, keep in mind, I was probably, what, like, 8? Okay, I didn't know much of nothing, but I knew who this bitch was, okay? I knew my woman. So then my dad asked me if I wanted to get it, and I was just like, like, it was just the biggest thing because, you know, I never in a million years would have thought I was gonna get a CD. Like, it was the biggest deal, and it was just, like, the most exciting moment. I remember it like it was yesterday. So anyways, all of that to be said, this is Shania Twain. I'll have this shirt linked down below, as long as it's still available. I got it on Torrid, and it is so cute, and it's just, like, an homage to my childhood, and it makes me smile, and I love a good memory. I love a good story, so I had to share it, despite the fact that now my intro is, like, 13 minutes long. But anyways, getting into the makeup, okay, I'm so sorry. Oh my God. Ugh, eyeballs. Okay, this has happened to me so many times lately when I'm filming. This is Northern Michigan. We don't have sun. Get out of here, sir. Go, 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 go. It's in my eyeballs. Anyways, as I was saying, this is from Clarins, and this is their Blur and Matte Stick, and it says that it has the extract of strawberry tree fruit, and I was just all about it. So I thought we would take and maybe, ooh, oh my God, it smells like, oh my God, this smells so good. It smells like, kind of like a very light strawberry, like a strawberry shortcake, kind of. Like, it has like a creamy smell to it. Ooh, that smells great. Okay, let's go ahead and just take and kind of massage it in. I find that anytime you're going in with something that's meant to be more of like a pore filling type primer, it does work best to really work it into the pores in a circular motion. Okay, excuse me, what is happening? Okay, so don't want to be here. Got it. If I'm here, am I good? Hopefully. I feel like I spend half my life trying to fight this. And you guys know, I gave up on the whole, you know, have a perfect filming setup like weeks ago at this point. But does it stop me from not wanting to be blinded by the sun? Absolutely not. Okay, it still burns my retinas. So I just want you to like not exist. Thank you so much. Okay, so far that actually feels really nice. It is super duper soft, which I appreciate. Like, I'm not noticing a huge amount of what I would say is like blurring. Like, my pores are still very much so visible, but I really like the texture of it. Like, it's very, very silky soft on my skin, and it's not giving me any finish, which I like. It's not matte, it's not hydrating. It's just the kind that like sits in and kind of presses in, kind of like a silicone primer, kind of like that. But it smells fantastic. Oh my God, that light strawberry scent. Oh God, that smells great. All right, now next up is the item that I have in here that is on the newer-ish side. But you guys, I have been so excited to try this, and I literally have not had one moment, like one video where I could sneak it in. And this is the new M Cosmetics Daydream Cushion Protect and Perfect little like CC cream compact cushion situation. And I am so excited. I have seen this on models. I've seen it on Kathleen Lights. I've seen it on everybody. And it just looks so gorgeous. Now, along with this, because I know the coverage isn't gonna be that great, and I'm not really looking to like build up a ton of coverage, but I know that with a CC cream and, you know, something that's more geared like this product is, I am gonna need a little help over like my really intense redness, whether it's here, around my nose, stuff like that. And so I wanna introduce as well the concealer I'm gonna be testing today, and that is actually the KVD Lock It Concealer, which, guys, I have never tried this. I don't know what's going on, but I feel like everyone has tried this. So really, and like I said at the start, you know, these kind of videos are meant to be more fun. I can play around with coverage and stuff like that, but at the end, I still do want to achieve a look, you know, that looks nice, where we can fairly test everything. And so I'm gonna go in first and grab the cushion compact. I think this is the best place to start, and that way we can put it over, you know, just the primer. We can see how the coverage is with this alone, and then we can go in and build up and play around with the concealer and all of that. That way we're still able to see like what this product does by itself, but then also kind of get the desired outcome, which is like a medium-ish coverage for me. That's what I'm looking for. I'm gonna start off here by, well, of course, removing this little protective. I actually really like too this little thing that it comes with. This is the little pad. It feels very nice, super soft. It's more of like a light microfiber. This isn't one of those cheap crappy ones that you get in a lot of other compacts. This one actually feels great, and I love the shape. If you wanted to like get around your nose and stuff like that, this is really, really good. But let's go ahead. What shade did I grab this into? I have it in, I would assume, one of the lighter shades here. Hello, do we know what shade I bought this in? Light medium. I have it in gentle light, light medium. Okay, that is the version. And again, everything that I'm using today, I'll have linked down below. But let's go ahead here, peel this little protector off. And oh, is that a little dark for me? Well, I mean, it's probably a little dark for me. Who am I kidding? Everything's a little dark for me. I'm gonna start off on my red area right here. That way we can actually get a look at the coverage first and kind of see. Oh my God. You guys, I smell the sunscreen. It makes me think of summer. It just takes me back, and I love it because it makes me think of like when I was a kid and when we would go to the beach. Oh my God, because hello, Northern Michigan, the Great Lakes State, okay? Like, oh my God. The memories that I have attached to sunscreen. It's so weird, but I love it. All right, so far, I'm just, you know, still working it in here. I am doing more of like a press-in motion than I am like a swiping motion. I think that it's helping me maintain a little bit of the coverage. And I have to say too, for a CC cream, this actually does have a decent amount to it. Like, I'm noticing the redness that's over this area. You know, yes, you can still see my acne poking through, but it's actually not as bad as I would have expected. Like, I thought this would be more of a sheer wash, which is nice. And I like the fact too that with that coverage, it's actually really workable. Like, you can decide if you want to sheer it out, if you're having more of like a lackadaisical, you know, going out or running errands kind of day, or you can build it up a little bit, which is nice too. I think on camera, it does pull a little bit warm yellowish, but it actually looks really pretty, and it's so hydrated. Like, my skin looks so fresh and glowy. Oh, this is pretty. All right, so I think I'm gonna be done with that compact. And by the way, too, this little packet, not only do you get that one compact, but you also do get a replacement. So just FYI, it's not like when you purchase it, you're just getting, you know, the one dish with the one thing. They do send you a full-on replacement as well, which I think is really nice. And it actually feels like it comes with another sponge in there, which is great, like, hygienically. And now from there, I am gonna move on to the Lock It Concealer. So it looks like, okay, that I grabbed this in actual paper white. It's the shade L1 Neutral, so light one neutral. And we're just gonna start going in here. I'm gonna assume, oh, this, she's a thick lady. I'm gonna assume that this is the lightest shade. Whoops. So let's go ahead here. I'm just gonna grab my sponge and start blending it out. Cause oh wow, is she thick and oh, is she light? Okay, probably not the right shade. Like furthering the, you know, the blend, putting a little bit under the eyes, through the T-zone, that type of thing. I'm actually not mad at this. I think it looks really pretty, like the brightness under my eyes. I just think it looks a little bit harsh because the shade all over my face is a little bit too yellow. But you know, honestly, the concealer itself, not too shabby. It's blending out really nicely. I don't think that the coverage is as intense as I expected, if I'm being honest. Like up through here, I can still see my blue bags kind of poking through. But I do think as far as like a medium coverage concealer, it's not too awful bad. I am gonna use a little bit of it though, I think down here along the jawline, just to lightly kind of sculpt this area, because this area is where it's, you know, not matching my neck. So I wanna make sure that everything blends well. Okay, so normally, and I think I said this before, normally I would build up this area and add a little bit more coverage over my redness, but I wanna make sure that I have a little bit of it, you know, still poking through for when I test out the KVD Locket foundation. Like I wanna see what that coverage looks like as well. So instead of going in and building up coverage there, I'm actually gonna move on and set the under eyes and the T-zone, I think, with this. This is the Becca Hydra Mist Set and Refresh Powder, and I have heard so many people talk about this, and I feel like it's actually a very polarizing item. Like the people that love it and swear by it and like live by it every single day, and then the people that hate it absolutely loathe it and think it's disgusting. All right, now I have the little thing off. First thing I'm gonna say is I love this packaging. I love that it has the little lid here and that it actually has the little net so you can press your sponge into it and then set your under eye. Really, really love that. There's not like nearly as much mess and fussing around with it, which is great. So I'm gonna take here, grab my sponge one more time and press out these under eye bag, these little wrinkles, because I got wrinkly ass, crevassy little under eyes, you guys know. I mean, if you don't, by the way, hello, I've got wrinkly ass under eyes that are crevassy as hell, because I'm 31 years old, and like, that's just what happens to some of us. Not a big deal, doesn't matter. We're just going to beat it back out here, and then take our sponge, as per usual, and dip into some of this powder and try to set it. For me, with under eye like setting powder type situations, I don't often have great luck with something that has this fine of a mil, because if you can't tell on camera, this is like a very, very, very micro fine setting powder. And I find that a lot of times my under eyes, more so than anything, just eat. Like they eat this for breakfast and spit it out into my under eye bags. And so I don't expect this to be like a miracle working powder by any means, but I still wanted to, you know, obviously, like I said, give it a fair shot because so many people do love it. I can see a blurring effect from this for sure, like over the pores, the fine lines, but I can also see on the downside where it's going to be kind of settling into my fine lines and wrinkles. So I think for me, this one would probably work better, if I had to guess, as like a finishing powder type situation or something that, again, I use as a last step. But going in right now, I can definitely see why people like it. I like the light cooling sensation you get from it. I don't think it's anything revolutionary. Like, it's not that intense on my skin. Because this powder, if you don't know, it's supposed to have more of like a cooling, refreshing feeling. And I can feel that a little. But I don't think that it's something that like, oh wow, you know, it's not something where I'm like running crazy over here about it. All right, so next up, apparently I'm really into things that are the same shade as my white shirt, because this is the powder foundation from KVD. This is their Locket powder foundation in the shade Fair 105. And oh my God, like it actually blends in with the wall behind me. Paige, what were you thinking? I was thinking that I'm pasty, which is totally fair, but like, little bit light white, but you know what? We're gonna make it work. Whoa, oh, hello. Yeah, let's go ahead here. I'm taking this on an IT Cosmetics. This is their Velvet Luxe Plush Powder 313 made for Ulta. These are their line that they have specifically for Ulta, and they are so, so nice. Yeah, you're definitely gonna see me turn a very fun shade of ghost, I can tell. Like, look at, just putting a little bit right here versus this side, whoops. Yeah, so probably a little bit light for me. But that's fine, because the foundation was a little bit deep. And then, you know, to balance it, we add some this, and then we're gonna add a little bit of bronzer. It'll be fine. It'll be fine, guys. I like to think that for the most part, okay, like 90% of the time, everything comes out. Everything kind of comes out in the wash once I'm done adjusting all of my bad color decisions on my face. So we're gonna hope for the best here. I'm gonna take and lightly blend this down. This is a beautiful texture on this powder. Like, it feels so light and refined for a foundation powder. In terms of the coverage, I'm actually not mad at it because I'm not really going through and, like, you know, intensely packing it on like a foundation powder. And so I didn't know kind of what to expect given that, you know, I, again, wasn't really going for a ton of coverage, but I like that right through here, it did just help to dull down this redness. All right, now next up, this one, it kind of shocks me. I can't believe, not kind of, it really shocks me that I haven't talked about these yet because the day that I got these in the mail, these next two items were from PR. And the day that I got them in the mail, I actually teared up over on Instagram because I got my acceptance into the Sigma affiliate program, and they sent these over. There, you know, there were brushes and sponges and brush cleaning stuff in the box, but they sent me over their new cheek palettes as well. And again, this was like maybe what, a year or more ago. I just can't believe that I never talked about these, like I never used them, because that day was so emotional for me. Oh, and by the way, if you guys don't know, it is listed in the description, but I do have a code with them. I believe it's code SEEKING, I want to say, for 10% off. For me, it was just such a big deal because I was in such a headspace where I felt like I didn't belong. I felt like I didn't matter. Like the beauty space just wasn't for me, which is so dumb because the beauty space is literally for anyone of anything. And I just, I remember thinking like, oh my God, like I matter enough. Like that means that somebody reviewed my channel. Somebody at Sigma watched me and they liked me enough. Like they fucked with me enough that they wanted me to be a part of it. And it wasn't even like I didn't have the confidence back then, but it was just, I don't know. There was something about being accepted by a brand that I love so much. Like I genuinely love them. I use their brushes. By the way, while I'm talking, how about I go ahead and start applying? I'm gonna go in with the Sigma Sculpt Highlight and Contour Palette first. Ooh, those look pretty. I think this one's definitely the most suited for my skin tone. But like, ooh, these are, oh my God, those other two all over the lid would be so beautiful. And those are actually really creamy. I thought at first, like when I first touched them, that they had a little bit of a thicker consistency. But then in swatching them, they actually feel pretty creamy. Going into this, I'm actually gonna take my Morphe JH02 brush here. It's just a fluffier kind of profile. And I'm just gonna start very lightly kind of brushing that back just to see what the color looks like. I find that it works better for me if I'm testing out like a new contour or bronzery type shade like this. If I start out by the hairline, that way if it looks absolutely atrocious, I can just kind of cover it up, wear my hair down, and you know, we're all set. So I like to always start with new shades like this, just farther back. And then as I like it or feel more comfortable, I'll kind of bring it in. Oh, that's actually really pretty. I like that it layers nicely. Like the consistency of it is really buildable and very workable. I can't stand bronzers or contour, stuff like that that's like super heavy because it makes it hard to work with. It makes it impossible to blend, and I can't stand that. I would rather have one that I have to dip into a couple of times and really build up. And this is really, that's actually really nice. And if anybody's wondering why, what page, why do you keep looking in the monitor? It's because anytime I do bronzer, anything like this remotely like this, it always turns orange. Always, even if it's not. And I'm really praying that this doesn't look too orange on camera right now, because in real life it looks so gorgeous, and I really want you guys to get to see like how nice it actually looks. We're gonna throw just a little light shadow on our Dorito Cheeto Cupcake region, okay? Not because we're ashamed of her, but just because, you know what, sometimes we don't need the judgment, okay, from the rest of the world. Like, yes, I'll own it, I ate 74 bags of Doritos. We're not gonna talk about it, and you're not gonna talk about it either, because bitch, you can't tell because I shadowed that shit and now it looks like I only ate one cupcake. Yes, please. All right, so next up, here is the blush palette. First of all, packaging gorgeous. Second of all, these shades are stunning. All right, so I went ahead and swatched them. These two on the end right here are shimmery blushes, and then the other four are more matte toned blushes, and I really like them. And you know, they're not even like a harsh matte. They're more of like a satiny kind of matte, which is beautiful, and it always translates gorgeous to the skin. I think what I want to do for today is actually go in and mix these two shades. I love the more mauvey tone of this one, but it is a little intense, so I want to lightly tap it into the shimmery, like tangerine type shade. That way, it'll not only adjust and kind of lighten the color, but it'll also add that lilt to it, like that little added sheen to the cheek. So I'm just going to take and lightly tap that on. And I think I'm going to keep it a little bit farther back today. Yeah, I like that a lot. I think that it's gonna continue to kind of snatch up the face. Okay, so change of plans. I was gonna just go ahead and finish up the face, do highlight out of the contour palette and call it a day. But I'm noticing up under my eyes right here that they are starting to get a little bit darker, and I don't think it's pulling as intense on camera. But in real life, like the shadow right here needs to be fixed a little bit. So I'm actually going to go ahead, because I don't have anything new for brows. So while I do my brows off of camera, I'm just gonna let some of my No. 7 Lift and Luminate powder press into this area. That way we can just kind of brighten and relift that whole little blue socket right there. And hopefully, the goal is, by the time I'm done with my brows, hopefully it's a little bit corrected. So I'm just gonna take, I don't need a ton of sculpting on the rest of my face because I'm not really going that heavy with my base makeup, like for bronzer and blush and stuff. But I still wanna make sure that, you know, it has a little bit of light shaping. And then from there, I'm just going in with the Benefit Duo here. This is the Precisely My Brow Pencil in 3.5. And then after that, we're gonna use the Gimme Brow Gel for that nice little floofy brow gel. This is also in 3.5. All right, now with the brows on, I'm gonna go ahead and spray my face. That way we can move in with highlight. And for that, I don't have anything new, so I'm just gonna grab my Catrice Dewy Glow Setting Spray. That feels good. Then going back into that Sigma Contour and Highlight Palette, I am gonna grab my Furless Cosmetics. This is their Pro 5M Fan Brush. And I am just gonna tap into the Shine On shade. It's the lightest one in the palette here. Okay, so I love this brush, but I hate the fact that I can't fit it in the pan. I feel like it's giving me a weird shape on my face. So I have to switch out. I'm actually gonna go in instead with this one. This is my Pat McGrath Highlight Brush. This is just an old one. It doesn't even have a name on it, but it's just like a stipple style. And I like to take this brush, we can tap in same way here, and instead of using it like in a swipey motion, I actually use it in more of a buffing motion, just to help kind of press the highlight in that much more. Oh, that's much, much better. I actually feel like this style is helping the highlight too, because it does have a little bit of a thickness to it on the skin. Like, I can see it kind of emphasizing this texture right here, not in the highlighter aspect, but just in the thickness of the product. Take a little bit here down the bridge of the nose, Cupid's bow, and then of course my little chalupa chin, honey. Yes, my little hashtag chalupa chin right here. Gotta get that greasy little chalupa grease moment. Not too much, not too intense, okay? Just a little grease, and it looks really pretty. I actually love this shade. Again, not obsessed with the way that it's settling into the skin. Like, I think the sit could be better, but the look of it's gorgeous. The shade is like really flattering. And I think while I'm here, just to go in and help with that little bit of texture that I'm seeing on the cheeks, I'm gonna grab my tried and true Halo Setting Powder from e.l.f., my Halo Glow Setting Powder, and I'm gonna start it up in this area because that's where the texture is the worst, and then lightly just kind of blend it down. All right, now going in for eyes, I don't want to do anything that's gonna be like super intense, because obviously we have this more, you know, natural medium-esque coverage kind of look going on, but I did want to dabble into this palette. This is from Urban Decay. It's their Elements palette, and I don't even know if this palette is still available or not. I think that I got this, I want to say maybe it was either in a BoxyCharm or I found it on sale like on Ulta or something, but I really, really love the shades in it. Like, the layout for me is kind of a bummer because you could have fit like way more shades in here, and that's just a personal pet peeve for me. We've talked about this, but I really like the shades, and I thought it would be kind of fun to at least play around with some of them. Again, maybe staying on the lighter side, we have Electric Air. Ooh, what is this one? Fortune Teller. That looks like kind of a duochrome-y, like pewter type shade. That's really pretty. Ooh, and then that shade in the center, Luna, it's almost like an iridescent white type situation. These are really pretty. Is this palette still available? I'm gonna have to check. This is so, oh my God, these are gorgeous though. Oh my God, like these are so pretty. Okay, yeah, let's go ahead. This is what we're gonna do. Guys, I was so hesitant. I'm like, yeah, maybe I'll just put bronzer through the crease. And now I'm just like, bitch, let me in. Like, I gotta play around with some of it. Let's go ahead and first off, start by priming the eyelids a little bit here. I'm just gonna use my Incognito Concealer from Wet n Wild. This is in the shade Fair. Then from there, with that primed, I'm gonna take it while it's tacky and put the shade Antidote right here. It's like a light kind of beigey brown shade. And I'm actually gonna put that on with the BH V17, which is a really, really fat, fluffy brush. And I'm using this one because I want this shade, like I said before, I wanted it to be more of a light look. And I really want this shade to be like the predominant crease color all the way through here. So I'm just gonna take and lightly do this. This is actually something I've been doing a lot lately, just because it helps like get the crease done in a matter of seconds, and then lightly blend the edges. And this brush is so great, you guys. It works amazing if you wanna do highlight, like up on the high points of your cheek, if you wanna do under eyes, like really pressing in like that No. 7 powder, if you wanna use it for that, wiping away powder, whatever you wanna use it for, this brush is so, so good. Oh, you gotta rock down to Electric Avenue. Then you take it higher. Fun fact, that actually used to be my mom's ringtone on my Razer flip phone. Yes, you heard me right. My Razer flip phone. It was red and beautiful. And that was my mom's ringtone. It was great. Every time she called me, da-da-da, rock down to Electric Gabba New every single time. And everybody loved it, myself included, because it had some vibey goodness to it. Oh, so good. Okay, now from there, I'm going to take the same brush, and I'm actually going to go in to the shade Elemental right here. It's just a slightly deeper matte toned, kind of warm-ish brown. And those two shades are actually the only two matte shades in this entire palette. And I've talked about this before, but when it comes to palettes like this one that only have a couple of crease colors, or this one, this is the Mothership Mega Celestial Divinity palette. Stuff like this where there's only, you know, one or two like regular, what I would call regular brown or pinky nude type shades that are matte and then the rest are shimmer, does not bother me one bit because I actually love palettes like this. I feel like they have so much ease to them. Like I can pick up the palette and literally run two colors or one color through the crease, like a brown or a pinky neutral. That one has more pinky type nudes. You can run that through the crease and then just swipe the shimmer on and you're good to go. It's super simple and you can always kind of reach for something different. Like you can reach for a different shimmer or a different, you know, depth or a reflector. I feel like you have a lot of options if you're someone like me who really loves to play around with the shimmery part of your eyelid. So for me, this just, it doesn't faze me at all. And I really like it. I feel like these palettes are fun. Now, over top of that, I think I am going to take the shade Fortune Teller. That was that kind of duochrome-y shade. And I'm going to pop that all over the lid. Now, normally, you guys know, or maybe you don't know if you're newer, but normally I would be popping a glitter glue down. I love glitter glue. The NYX glitter glue primarily is like my go-to. It's super inexpensive. And if you are like me and you have more inhospitable eyelids, it is the thing you need, okay? You need it in your life. So just highly recommend. But for today's look, I'm not grabbing that because I don't want to add any like extra intensity because I want this look to be a little bit more like sheared out, a little less intense. So from there, I'm actually going to take, because I love that shade, I want to just add a little more dimension on the inner corner. I'm going to take Electric Chair right here. I'm going to pop that just going up onto the lid in the inner corner, not on the actual inner corner, just like right on this portion of the lid. And then over top of that as well, I'm going to take the shade Luna right here, the one in the center, and I'm going to use that shade to even give it a little bit more brightness. Again, this is more of a translucent-y iridescent kind of shade, so it's not going to give me a ton of payoff, but it's just going to help reflect the light and have it have that much more pop to it on the inner corner right there. And then just for a little bit of extra pop here, I'm taking that same Fortune Teller shade that we took all over the lid, and I'm running that on the lower lash line just for a little wash of color. Also, I'm going to go back in with the highlight out of the Sigma palette and do my inner corner and my brow bone just a little bit here. I'll kind of pop it in this area just to make sure everything is nice and open. Okay, am I the only one? Like, I'm really starting to wonder about myself. You know how, like, we all go through makeup phases and, I feel like our preferences change. Like, if you want a bold brow, a light brow, if you want intense eye makeup or, you know, really full coverage, then light coverage. I feel like makeup preferences change. But, like, I feel like for me, I'm really going through it, like, with this, like, easy, neutrally kind of eye look. I want to have all the different colors and stuff. Like, I love playing around with that. But I want everything to be super fast and simple on my eyes. And am I the only one going through that? Like, is this like an internal thing or what? Is anybody else feeling this the way I am? Because I am so obsessed. Like, my eye looks are super simple, but they're always so fun. And I just love adding little pops of things here and there. And I just want to know, am I the only one? Please tell me down below because I'm obsessed. All right, now really quick too, I'm just going to give myself one more little spritz of the Catrice Dewy Glow Setting Spray, just to keep everything nice and locked in. And then for mascara, I actually have two different options here. I have the Jane Iredale Longest Lash Thickening and Lengthening Mascara. And this one I grabbed actually at the same time that I grabbed the Jane Iredale Glow Time Full Coverage Mineral BB Cream. And I was thinking, because I bought these like when they first launched to Ulta, what, maybe like five-ish, maybe more months ago, I don't know. And I've been dying to test these out. I still haven't tested them. They've been actually sitting in this bin. And I was wondering if maybe I should do like a video with this one, the mineral cream, maybe like over on Instagram or something, or maybe I should just wait and incorporate it into one of these. I don't know. But anyways, I picked up this mascara, same time I picked up this. And I am really, really curious to see if it's any good. In addition to this, I also have the KVD Go Big or Go Home Volumizing Mascara. And I am all about volumizing mascaras. Like, it's kind of my heart and soul. And so I don't really know. You know what? I'm going to open up the KVD one first because I feel like this one, I have, ooh, wow, this packaging is gorgeous. I love this. I feel like I've heard a lot of people talk about this. Like the wand, oh wow, is that supposed to be that thick? That is like thick and dry as hell. Is it supposed to look like that? Does anybody know? Do you know anything about this mascara? Okay, so let's, you know what? Maybe we just hold on to this for 1 second. Let's also go look at the Jane Iredale one. Okay, so I love the wand. It's like a nice full body bristle moment, which I am all for. It appears to have like the little fluffies in there, which I'm not mad at. That's like kind of what helps give volume and stuff. All right, so I think what we're gonna do is try both, because I'm thinking that this KVD one is like either too thick or there's something, I don't know, maybe it's like old, like maybe it's too old. I didn't buy it that long ago though, did I? I don't think I did. So yeah, we're gonna give it a try. I'm just gonna scrape off a bunch of this excess product here, and I will start off with this one. Oh wow, she is thick and it feels real hefty, real thick lady we got going on here. I do notice that I have to kind of go over top of them again once they're coated to like keep them separated and not like all clumped together, but like they're not doing awful so far. So I'm actually gonna pause. I'm gonna let these ones partially dry down. I like to let my lash coats kind of wait and get, you know, like 50% dry before I build them up. So I'm gonna pause here and go in with the other side with the Jane Iredale mascara and get this side good and coated. Wow, these two mascaras could not feel more different from each other. This one is more of a like thin formula that's coating the lashes very, very nicely, very evenly, and it's not thick or clumpy at all. Whereas the other side, again, was more of a thick, hefty type formula. This is so interesting. Like, these two side by side, they look nothing alike. You know what's really interesting about these is I feel like each side has what the other one needs. Like, this one from KVD is looking, like, way thicker on the lashes, but they're also looking really short and stubby and, like, just little stumpy lashes. But this side over here, I think I'm going to mix them together a little bit, because this side, the Jane Iredale, it actually needs a little bit of that thickness, but it has really good length going. So I'm gonna add a coat to each side and just try to mix these. All right, so I went ahead and finished up the mascara, and then I threw on this liner that I found in my drawer. It's from Dose of Colors, and it's just their basic black. It's in the shade Caviar, and I really, really like this. It's a super creamy eyeliner, and like, look at that. And like, the shade is beautiful. Look at, oh my God, it's really, really creamy, super emollient. So I went ahead and obviously added that to the upper and lower waterline. And then moving on to lips, I actually have this little duo from NARS. This is in the shade Intriguing. It has their Velvet Matte Lip and their Lip Tint, both of which are, again, in the shade Intriguing. So what I'm gonna do is take the lip crayon. I just really loved this color. I'm actually, you know what, maybe we should wipe off these crusty, busty-ass little lips first. Oh my God, get that off of there. No wonder I've been sitting here eating foundation for this whole video going, why does that taste nasty? Probably because you're licking whatever remnant of crusty, busty foundation is left on your lips. So let's go ahead here and just line this out. Now that I look at it, is this shade gonna match the eyes? I honestly don't know. Let's figure it out. We'll just figure it out as we go, it's fine. So I'm gonna take, and just lightly, oh wow, that's such a soft texture. I don't think I've ever used these from NARS before. This is so nice. Like the texture is super light and powdery in the best way. Well, maybe we shouldn't talk while we're like lining our lips, Paige, good call. But yeah, the texture of this is really soft and buttery in like a soft matte kind of way. And I really, really like that. It's like a barely there feeling at all. This is really comfortable for any sort of a matte product. I really, really like that. And then over top, I thought that this was a gloss, but it's, again, more of a tint, or so it says. But it definitely looks to be kind of glossy. I don't know. Let's go ahead. We'll pop a little bit over top. Okay, so I like the fact that this has a little bit of sheen to it, because, you know, I think that if you were going for like a more natural-esque look and you just wanted something that was a little pink and a little bit there but not too overdone, this would actually work really, really well for that, because it gives you, again, the sheen, the color, and that wash. But at the same time, I think you could really work with it. You could lightly tap it out and you're not going to have to worry about it being like overbearing in any one direction. That's really nice. Mmm. And I actually like the texture. It's super smooth, and the two of those pair really well together. And all right, you guys, with that, of course, I am done with the full face, and I'm gonna go tame this hair in a second once I'm done filming this. I know that that's kind of the opposite to like the whole beauty spectrum thing, but like, let's be honest, my curling iron is like in there, like in the bathroom, and like I'm all the way in here, so like I'm not gonna like get up, go do it, come back. It's just, it's a whole thing, and besides, I'm having too much fun arguing with this little patch of sunshine, so I figured we would just sit here, hello, and we would do the outro. I wanted to, of course, give you guys the up close, and I'm just gonna lean in because I miss you and the sun. Did I mention the sun? But anyways, let's go ahead and get into the close-up. So I'm gonna go ahead and put that up on the screen. That way you guys can see how everything is looking. I actually really, really like the texture overall. I think things are looking pretty good. My only issue is that, and I don't, maybe it's in the close-up, I don't know if you guys can see it or not, but I'm having an issue with fallout on my face, like all along the nose and the under eye area. And I don't know, like it's fallout definitely from a mascara, but I don't don't know which one because, again, I used two different mascaras. If I had to make an educated guess, okay, just like an educated, you know, thought process here, I would say it's from the Jane Iredale one because this is the one that actually had those little, like, hair-like kind of flicky things in them. And the one from KVD, I didn't see any of those. So I'm assuming that the little flickies are coming from this, and I definitely do not love that. So for me, but to be fair, though, I didn't really care for either of these mascaras, whether it's the formula, mine are just funky, I don't know. But I didn't care for either of them. I think that both of them, like in terms of the texture, they're too far on either end of the spectrum. The one is too thick and goopy and dry, and the other one doesn't really give me like any added benefit or added like volume to my lashes. So I would probably not, I mean, personally, I would probably never revisit either of those anyways, but I just wanted to mention it in case you're seeing like the little things that look like black confetti all over my face. That is what it's from. Anyways, moving on to the rest of the face. I actually think everything looks pretty good. I do think that my face overall, like in the pore refining department, I'm not really seeing as much of a meld there as I would like from that primer. I think for me personally, I would have to stick with more of like a Tatcha Liquid Silk Canvas, something that's a little bit more emollient and almost has a little bit more of like a thickness or a hydrating quality to it, because I think that this one sitting on my skin, it's almost pulling a little bit drier looking, and it's not giving me as smooth of a base right through here. So I don't know that that is necessarily the product for me, but overall everything else looks great. I actually love the way that it looks more on the natural side of things, like combining that the product from M Cosmetics that had more of like a light kind of tinted base, and then putting the foundation powder over top of it. Like I love that pairing because I think that it gives my skin a little bit more of a natural look, but I'm still getting medium-ish coverage, and it's actually a very like simple wearable type out the door option for me because I have to set my face anyways. But anyways, you guys, that is it for me. Make sure you leave me all of your thoughts and opinions down below, whether it is on the video, the products. Do you like these? Again, I know that they're not like super new launches, but I also know that not everybody cares about super new launches. And so I like to, you know, kind of diversify a little bit, throw these out here, products that I have been holding on to. And like, if I care enough to hold on to something, like, bitch, I need to use it and I need to see the tea, because otherwise I would have, you know, decluttered it, or I would have never purchased it in the first place. So yeah, for me, these were things I was curious about. Of course, you guys can let me know down below. Do you like them? What are your thoughts, opinions? Y'all know the drill. Leave it in the comments. And like I said at the start, I will have everything I used as much as possible. I'll have it all linked in the description box, shirt included, the necklace and all that. This is actually from Melinda Maria, same as these hoops. So I'll have all of that linked as well. Oh, and duh, by the way, hello. I'm like the best YouTuber over here. Don't forget to subscribe. Turn on your post notifications. I know I said that already. And please make sure too that you go follow me on Instagram, all of which would be greatly appreciated. And I will have linked down below. And I think that that is it, you guys. Thank you all so much for watching. Please don't forget to have an amazing day, night, weekend, whatever it is when you're watching this. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye. What is this? Look at this. What is this? Looks like something you'd play with if you were a cat, like a big ball of yarn. How about this? Does this work? Can I just do this? No? Okay. A little distracting? Maybe. Looking good. Looking good in the neighborhood. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. I'm loving it. Wasn't that like four different food metaphors? Dude, I must be hungry. Okay, like my subconscious is very starving right now. Very hungry. I got Shania all covered in powder. Excuse me, ma'am. Excuse me, ma'am. Sorry, Shania. Maybe I could just, you know, film my other video like this, just like hanging out on the ground. Look at this. Just like, and no matter where I go, it's always there. It burns. It's so bright. Okay, stop it right now. Thank you so much, son. I'm not used to you. I don't know if you've noticed, but I don't know your kind.